So recently, a whole lot of people have been asking me about how I take notes that look like this and what sort of techniques I use to make them. And I was in the process of making that video when I started to realize that this whole thing is so much more than just taking some notes and using some techniques or tips. It's actually about how I learn. Because my notes, for example, are just a reflection of what goes on inside my head when I'm trying to learn. And so today I'm gonna try and show you how I learned, how I ended up learning this way, and finally, I'm gonna talk to you about the secret principle that I use whenever I try and learn anything. In fact, you're actually gonna be surprised because it's something so obvious, and you've probably heard it so many times before, but it's actually more profound than you think. But before we get to that, to all the people who left questions on my previous videos, I just wanted to say thank you very much for all those questions. And this video is just the start. Before we go on, I think it's important for me to give you a bit of history, because as I said, things haven't always been pretty. My first semester of university was a disaster. You see, throughout my entire school life, my relationship with learning was a bit stuffed up. I always had that desire to learn stuff and discover new things, but for some reason, it seemed as though nearly everything I did in school ended up with memorizing stuff. And I hate just blindly memorizing stuff. And I think you know what I mean, because there's something robotic about just sitting down and regurgitating facts that can just be searched up on a computer. In fact, I hated it so much that when it came to choosing my subjects for the last few years in school, I chose subjects that I thought I wouldn't need to memorize for. But you see, I was in a bit of a mess when it came to my first semester of university, because I ended up doing a course that revolved around subjects like biology, anatomy, physiology, and chemistry. And I had no idea how to approach studying or learning these subjects, because in the past I had just run away from them. And so I decided to do what any young responsible individual would do in such a circumstance. I searched up YouTube, and I literally spent hours watching other people study, and I was shocked at the different ways in which people go about it. Some people would just take their lecture slides and start rote learning. Other people would take their notes and start verbally reciting them. Some people rewatch their lectures multiple times. Others would turn the whole course's content into a set of flashcards. And on top of that, there were like different learning types. There were visual learners, there were audible learners, there were learners that learnt by touch, and others were just simply brilliant memorizers. And they would all do pretty well, and they'd all get pretty good grades in school and university. And so I started to imitate them and apply what they were doing to my own life. I'd be making flashcards, I'd be taking notes, and in all honesty, I was doing a lot of work to almost create the illusion to show other people that I was doing a lot of work, if you know what I mean. But yet again, the semester ended with like a whole lot of cramming, and I somehow managed to get through it. I guess what I was looking for all this time was a recipe, a formula, a set of instructions that I could just blindly follow to learn. I wanted 10 steps to success that I could just take and apply to everything that I was learning. But then I eventually realized that that itself was the problem. I just wanted to blindly follow a recipe without even thinking. Because if you think about it, that's completely illogical, because there's so many variables that can affect your learning. For example, what type of subject are you learning? Are you learning a conceptual subject like physics? Or are you learning a subject that's full of content like biology? And then there's just like the general resources you have available to you. And so when I realized this, I made it my aim at the beginning of my second semester to figure out an approach to learning that actually worked. And not just a set of instructions, but an approach that I could adapt based on the subject. And so it was at this time where a couple of people shared with me a few videos on YouTube that were very helpful. But the thing was, this time around, instead of just blindly following a method of learning, I actually asked myself, what is the fundamental principle that's behind these methods of studying that makes them work? Why are they successful? What is the secret to learning? And it all started to make sense to me one day when I was teaching a friend of mine. And so I was teaching them, I think it was a concept in chemistry. And this particular concept took me weeks to learn. In fact, I learned it by just repetitively doing multiple questions. And I still remember that day because my friend just kept asking me question after question after question. And at the end of about 15 minutes, he was able to understand the stuff that had taken me weeks and weeks to learn in such a small amount of time. And I don't know how to put this into words, but it was almost as though as I was answering his questions, it was like he was taking pieces of a puzzle and putting them together. In fact, by the end of the 15 minutes, I would say that he had a better understanding than me of that topic. And it was all because he asked the right questions. I mean, it seems so simple, right? It's so obvious because, in a sense, we're all born with it. I mean, go find a 5, 6, 7, 8-year-old, and all they do is ask questions. They're a question bank. And they'll ask one question, and then they'll ask another question. And they'll ask another question, and each question connects to the previous question, and you can almost see it in their mind. They're putting something together. They're joining the dots, and that's probably the best analogy that I have. It's like joining the dots, except each dot is like a question. Now, this is probably seeming very abstract and not connected to reality, but you'll be surprised, because I took this approach, this learn like a child, a join the dots approach, into my second semester of university, and it changed the way that I learned. In fact, I'll take you through one of the parts of the lectures that I use this method for, okay? And so I decided to choose the digestive system lecture because I think it's something that a wide range of people would already have a sort of understanding of. As you can see, when I went into the lecture, I was no longer worried about having all the answers. I was more focused on coming out with the questions. And as you can see, one day in a lecture, as I was annotating my slides on my iPad, I jotted down the main questions that were going on inside my mind during that lecture. And so these are my dots. And so once I got home, it was just a case of joining the dots. Now, if you're not interested in seeing a detailed breakdown of this process, I'll leave a timestamp right here so you can skip this section and get to the conclusion of this video. But for those of you who decide to stay, I think you'll be very interested. So my first question was, so what does it mean to digest something? And that seems very obvious. The answer is to break things down. But then I asked myself, so what are we breaking down? What's being broken down during digestion? And then to make things more easy for me to grasp, I drew something that was visual. So I drew a burger. So that's the bread, that's the meat, and that's the cheese. And I'm sorry that the cheese is in green, but the colors matter for later on. And as I was doing this, I realized, oh, this connects to what I learned in biology. In fact, it's something you all already know, right? The bread is a carbohydrate, the meat is a protein, and the cheese is a fat, or a lipid as we call it in biology. And then I had a follow-up question to all these things. What are we breaking these things down into? And then I went back to my biology and I realized we break down carbohydrates into simple sugars. And the fancy word in biology for that is monosaccharides. Saccharide meaning sugar. And then I went to protein and I know that proteins are broken down into amino acids. And then I remember at that time I didn't know what fat was broken down into. And so I Googled it up and then I realized, oh, fat is broken down into two things, glycerol and fatty acids. Now, because I didn't want to just memorize this blindly at the time, I thought, why don't I just create a visual representation of it? And so I saw a complicated fat molecule on the internet. I just simplified it down to this little square with three squiggly lines coming out of it. And where the squiggly lines were fatty acids, and the blue part was glycerol. But my next question was, so why exactly are we breaking these things down? And that's a very important question in physiology, and luckily at the time, it was on the lecture slide. The main reason we break down carbohydrates is so we can get energy out of them. The main reason why we break down proteins is so we can break them down to the amino acids and then use the amino acids to build up things in our own bodies. So that made sense. And then when I went to fats, I knew from biology at the time that fats are found in the membrane. So as you can see right now, what I've been doing is I've kind of been breaking down the lecture organically, right? And I'm just approaching it like a little kid, asking whatever question pops up inside my head, and I'm connecting it to what I already know. And the next question I asked was actually probably my most important question, and it was, where do these things get digested? But when I looked at the lecture slide, it says, carbohydrate digestion happens primarily in the mouth, protein digestion happens primarily in the stomach, and fat digestion happens primarily in the small intestine, and specifically a part of the small intestine known as the duodenum. Now, I knew all these things from anatomy, and what's crazy is the fact that the 15 minutes that I spent doing this formed my understanding of this entire lecture. In fact, they formed the way that I made my notes. Remember how I said at the start? My notes are just a reflection of the way that I learn. And if you take a look at my notes for this lecture, I visualized everything that was going on inside my head. See? Proteins, carbohydrates, and fats. And I show them all being broken down. And ever since then, this image has stayed in my mind and it's never left. And also, remember how I was talking about location? The mouth, the stomach, and the duodenum? Those three things formed the structure of my notes. So that's a bit of general anatomy right there. But as you can see, I have the mouth with carbohydrate digestion, I have the stomach with protein digestion, and I have the duodenum with fat digestion. And I carried out the same organic process of asking questions, so I set up the dots, and then I joined the dots. And then I visualized my process on the page. And it's crazy because I think a lot of people, when they speak to me, they think I've memorized this all, but the honest truth is, I just broke down the lecture into questions. And do you know what the cool thing is? Once you have questions, things become so much easier because when you go to Google, the greatest search engine in the world, you know exactly what to search up and you can use it effectively. And when you read the textbook, you're no longer just reading it aimlessly because you know what you're looking for. And so you can skim read and you can focus on finding that small piece of information that you're looking for. And you can make judgments very quickly on what's relevant and what's not relevant. And finally, when you find that piece of information that you need, it's almost as though you've set up a framework within your mind in which you can place that piece of information. It's weird, I can't explain it in words, but things become a bit more meaningful and you have direction, sort of like a map. And essentially you're taking your brain into uncharted territory, somewhere it's never been before. So the secret to learning, for me personally, is taking something complex and then breaking it down into its smallest bits, a bit like your own digestive system, except for your brain. And once you've broken it down, you build it up into something else. And so I break things down using questions. And one of the ways that I build things up is through making notes. But when you look through my notes, every single part of my notes answers some question that I've had inside my head at some point. And I like to take the time to make things look good and be as visual as possible because I feel as though that whole process of going through that implants the image of the page within my mind. But yeah, I'll talk about my notes in more depth in a future video. But as you can see, for me personally, it's all about joining the dots. It's all about making those connections, and that's where true learning happens. Yeah, I hope I've been able to somewhat explain to you what sort of goes on inside my brain when I'm trying to learn, and this whole principle of asking questions. But honestly, it goes beyond just academics and getting marks in school and university. Because for me, it's the way that I approach everything. And this video has just been the start because I've only scratched the surface of what this topic really is. And so if you have any questions or ideas or suggestions or anything you just want to say, please leave them in the comments because this video is just the first video in a whole series of videos that I intend to make on learning, education, and teaching, and also stuff on the iPad Pro. I think that's a good place to leave it actually. And for all of you who've made it to the end of this video, I just wanted to say thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.